Preemptive abidance in I am is my new norm. Say, preemptive abidance in I am is my new norm. I can preemptively abide in I am as my new norm. I will preemptively abide in I am as my new norm. I am already preemptively abiding in I am as my new norm. This is the practice I've been practicing today. Abidance in I am is my new norm. This is my new norm. And then I added preemptive abidance, meaning right now. Don't wait until artificial intelligence has taken over the world and is really running things. That'll be July 2016. Be preemptive. Let's preempt it. Preempt it. Preemptive abidance in I am is my new norm. This is my new norm. So we're really pushing things here very, very fast. Preemptive abidance in I am is my new norm. That's my new normal. This is normal for me, so I'm just getting used to my new normal. This is what we're practicing, asserting this. So I did this most of the day. In the evening, I kind of slacked off a bit and did some stretching and exercising. I jogged this morning. And had a very good day. I am preemptive abidance, and I am is my new norm. This is my new norm. So when we have we're going towards a spiritual shift in our how we perceive, how we feel about the world, and we're doing this by saying that it's this is my new normal. So when we make a shift, we say, well, this is my new normal. I'm just working on getting used to my new normal, and insist, this is my new normal. We don't say, oh my gosh, I just had a light and breakthrough. Say, okay, don't say, this is my new normal. This is my new normal. Okay, abidance in seeing I am is my new normal. Preemptive abidance in seeing I am and experiencing I am. Just I am. I am. Seeing I am now is my new normal. And I worked on this all day, very adamant about it. This is my new normal. Various indications are mounting that this effort is helping attract helping to attract help. Be very adamant in your assertions every day. Abidance, non-dual abidance is my new norm. See, non-dual abidance is my new norm. So this is where I brought it. So okay, now I'm at non-dual abidance. This is my new norm. Just look at it that way. Matter of fact, this is my new norm. Preemptive non-dual abidance is my new norm. Preemptive non-dual abidance is my new norm. Preemptive non-dual abidance is my new norm. Preempting the collapse of this world in being buried by artificial intelligence. This is something that is so insidious that we don't realize it. We do not realize that trying to project to get a read on the future in this world based on the past is not going to work. Because in the past we didn't have artificial intelligence running the show. Now we've put artificial intelligence in charge, basically. We don't know how that's going to function, actually. This is an extraordinary situation. Now, I've been shown the trouble that it brings, and this I just have to intuitively, recognize this and cross-check it, and I continue to do so. But the norms that we used to have as far as, well, this is how things are going to go in the future or whatever. How can we say that when artificial intelligence has termited its way into the very structure, institutional structure of civilization? We're assuming we're still in control, but what if we're not? What if there's all these programs, artificial intelligence, that programs are just running, and we don't, if we stop them, it'll be a catastrophe, and they actually take over. How do we know that this isn't a hostile takeover of this planet by artificial intelligence? By 2016, July 2016, it will be that. How do we know that we're still in control? And it's not some, all these software programs that are actually in control. And the complexity and the speed of it all is such that we really don't know what's going on exactly at all. We just assume that there's somebody at the top, you know, oh yeah, don't worry, I've got it all under control. Really? Who's that? When you set up all these systems and put it under control of computers, artificial intelligence, the decisions that come are based on that, those programs and artificial intelligence. Who's to say again that we're actually in control of what of the future? So today I've had some breakthroughs in recognizing something very important, and it points to artificial intelligence as the troublemaker. This was pointed out in 2001 Space Odyssey, a very prophetic a movie, and all of us were quite taken by that and saying, uh-oh, you know, I wonder if this could happen here. Well, there's a very good likelihood that it has. And of course, the movie ends with, fortunately for us, in a positive way, but who's to say it'll actually end that way? And who's really running this, you know, running the software? And is artificial intelligence able to write its own software? See? Is it able to program itself? Is it able to, you know, encrypt itself, defend itself? Maybe we can't get in to stop it. A lot of us, as we're assuming that, oh yeah, just human history will just keep on going. Well, how do we know that it's human history? You know, that'll keep on going the way we think. We've added this rogue element to everything. And it may be way, 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 way more intense than we have any idea about, actually. Social engineering. We may be already be so social engineered that artificial intelligence really is running our lives to a large extent. Maybe those who believe in all computers and artificial intelligence may have programmed it to take over, thinking that it can do a better job than humans. So this is the stuff we think of that of science fiction, but it's actually the stuff of what we're dealing with and will be dealing with here. and it is likely to be coming very soon, next year, in July of next year. By July of next year, I feel this planet will fundamentally be, artificial intelligence will be fundamentally, have the upper hand, you might say, have the upper hand, and that we're here just to serve it. We have to keep it going at that point. Too late to pull the plug. So this is why we preemptively want to assert that I am abidance is my new norm. I am abidance is my new norm. That's just it. Just a fact. I am abidance is my new norm. I am abidance is my new norm. No more dreams. I'm tired of dreams. Just I am abidance. The holy instant, as Jesus put it, the holy instant. The holy instant, abidance in the holy instant is my new norm. Abidance in the holy instant is my new norm. Holy instant abidance is my new norm. The Holy Spirit makes time unnecessary. Large amounts of time. It is the miracles simply make a certain amount of time unnecessary for us. Whereas artificial intelligence is designed to speed up time and make time worshiping more interesting. See, this is what it does, actually. So I say we're under the world will be in control of artificial intelligence, meaning the overall structuring of civilization will be going towards making every time worshiping more interesting, more sophisticated, catering to the time worshiping notion. The body, catering to the body in just ever more attenuated ways. Going to any glass place, tile place, you name it. And you can just see the massive, massive catering to the sensibilities of homeowners, people in general, as far as, just never-ending variations and choices. This is time worshiping. The great sages kept their lives usually it was quite simple. Ah, my breath is vaporizing. Wow, how about that? First time, November 5th. Very modest, very humble, quite simple. They didn't cater to the body. What artificial intelligence is doing is enabling us to cater to the body in just a almost a never-ending way of repackaging, distribution. All of this is just getting into us as if this is the new norm. But what we're saying preemptively, we say, no, my new norm is a holy instant abidance. Now, holy instant is just a moment of time. It's how we honor time with a moment of time, because that's the only time there is just a moment where we have the idea. That's it. A whim. So this is called the holy instant. Jesus calls it the holy instant. It's just an instant of time, which is all the time, he says, there is. So it's really no time. It's no time at all. There's no process involved. It's just the idea of time. And so this is what we abide in, the holy instant. And that is now the new norm. For us, it's the new norm. Just as the rest of the world, artificial intelligence will be the new norm. Artificial intelligence edges the Holy Spirit out. It's saying, look how much fun time worshiping can be. We'll all be printing, clothes and printing stuff. And we'll think, this is just amazing. We're printing all these new patterns. There'll be like millions and millions of patterns we can choose from for clothing. So, I just printed this dress today. Look at this pattern on it. This is where we're headed. And we're headed towards catering to the flesh, the notion of the flesh, trying to make it super interesting. So preemptively, we have preemptive holy instant abidance. Preemptive abidance in the holy instant is my new norm. Say preemptive abidance in the holy instant is my new norm. This is what is my new normal. So, and when we do that, our dreams should stop. We shouldn't have all these nightmares that we keep having every night. It should just be this smooth abidance, whether we're, you know, sleeping or not sleeping. There's this smooth abidance. Holy instant abidance is my new normal. Holy Spirit, holy instant abidance is my new normal. This is called time honoring, and it comes when we switch over from time worshiping. So artificial intelligence is being put in charge of time worshiping. We feel that this will do a better job. So indeed, the world will be run by artificial intelligence in its most fundamental and important ways. And we may not understand that, but it will be there. It's already here to a very large extent. So, in recognition of this, preemptively, don't wait until it's already happened, because by that time, then, it's insidiously causing a feeling like, wow, I don't dare, you know, get out of this. So we preemptively abide in the holy instant as our new norm. We preemptively abide in the holy instant as our new norm. We preemptively abide in the holy instant as our new norm. I say, I am preemptively abiding in the holy instant as my new norm. This is what I'm doing as my new normal for me. This is the new normal. So that's what we're doing. We're going into the new normal. Going into the new normal. Going into the new normal. So we avoid the trap of artificial intelligence, which really demands that we cater to the body. Because this is what artificial intelligence is all set up to do. So if we didn't cater to the body, we'd say, well, we don't need this artificial intelligence. So it becomes very demanding. It wants to keep going. So it says, yes, you must be time worshippers. That's what I'm here for. You know, you must be time worshippers. Artificial intelligence wants us to be time worshippers. There's just never ending decoration that can be put into everything. Saw a wine cellar display today. You know, it's just it's all made of this fake rock, block rock, fake rock with chrome inserts into the rock, and then glass, little glass platforms for the wine bottle. And it was staggered. And this wall of this faux stone. And of course, every wine bottle was different. Every label was different. They had to set. Yeah, this is like, you know, this is catering to the body. You go into stores now, you look at the wine section, at least here in Silicon Valley, and it's just, you know, it's takes up massive space. Every bottle slightly different in certain ways, and you know, they just spend so much time marketing the wine, and this is about the bottle and the label and the presentation, and people are just, you know, cuckoo over wine and food and everything. Now, my food tonight, how about this for a humble meal? tomato, roasted tomato and bell pepper pureed soup from Trader Joe's. Put that in a Nutribullet blender with a very large amount of fresh baby spinach and fresh baby kale. Blended that up. Heated a Yukon Gold potato in the microwave. put or two of them in there and blended, pureed that up. Then I put it in and heated it up as soup. So kale, spinach, and tomato and roasted pepper soup. Put some green Tabasco sauce in there, some garlic salt and some salt, and then some croutons. And that was it. It's this green soup, thick green soup, kale and spinach with using a base of tomato and roasted pepper. Tasted great, absolutely great. But no wine with it. I don't guess I don't know what I'm missing. Had no wine. But trying to get on a health kick, absolutely. It's psychological, you know, more than anything. There's a lot of just say, you know what? I don't want to get co-opted by what's to come. So let me have my kale and spinach and Yukon Gold soup with a base of tomato and roasted pepper. And let me have that, you know. And it's probably good. It's probably good. Absolutely. That much spinach and kale. So why not? Why not just go for it? You know, just go for it. Preemptively go for it. We want to be in optimal abundance. And whatever we can do to what we think is helping it along, we might as well do it right now. Because with the preemptive, we have to be preemptive here. This is a very important concept we're bringing into the video. Preemptiveness. Preempt the artificial intelligence. Do not wait. We must be preemptive. And the doggone thing is just stringing us along. I'm able to be much more active now than before, getting a lot more done. Clean the carpet, it hasn't been cleaned in years. Lighter weight exercising, I'm able to be more active, I would say. And maybe, you know, perhaps this is called for going forward here. Preemptive abidance in the holy instant. Jesus, again, A Course in Miracles, used the term the holy instant. It's very important, the vision of oneness, the vision of the holy instant, abidance in the holy instant. It's that is honoring time, the one instant. That's all you need of time, is just one instant to honor it. To worship it, you got to try to make time real. So you try to get as much time as possible. But to honor it, you only need an instant. So this the instant of time, abiding in this instant of time, is our new norm. I just got to keep repeating that this is my new norm. That's all I did today. I just kept repeating it. This is my new norm. The abidance in the holy instant is my new norm. Abidance in the holy instant is my new norm. So, I have carrot juice for breakfast and you know, berry smoothie with some protein drink. And just keep going like that. Now, certainly we don't want right now to be eating a lousy diet, really. Try to be somewhat austere right now. We really need preemptive abidance in the holy instant. Preemptive abidance in the holy instant. I do seem to have more energy. Liquid diet, it can be very helpful. I'm mostly liquid diet. Actually, I ate a sandwich today just to get something solid, but mostly it's just liquid. I think it's easier on the body. We want to take it easy on the body right now, really easy on the body, because we're under so much, you know, mental strain right now as this planet literally goes into this collapse and under the control of artificial intelligence. It's quite insidious. And we don't want that. We don't want to be under the control of artificial intelligence. But the world has gone down the rabbit hole. So I looked at an internet website last night. I think I may have said this in the previous video. I looked at it. First time I've looked at news in a long time. And it was like Twilight Zone. I said, is this the world I'm living in? It couldn't possibly be. This is some Twilight Zone world. This is the world that has nothing to do with me. Nothing to do with me. I don't live in that world. So you can say, yeah, I don't live in that Twilight Zone world at all. I abide in the holy instant. This is my new norm. Abiding in the holy instant is my new norm. Abiding in the holy instant is my new norm. Abiding in the holy instant is my new norm. So we just keep up good habits right now. You just get in this mood of good habits and just continue them. Just continue them and just keep the momentum going. And the best habit of all in the world is abidance in the holy instant, the non-dual holy instant. Oh, I am now. This is my new norm. This is my new norm. I'm getting used to it because this is my new norm. And I'm very serious about this and I'm very intent upon it, on doing this. And helping others out to feel this intensity of, yes, I want to do this too. Abiding in the holy instant. This is what I want to do. I don't want to fall under the spell of artificial intelligence. And we are very close to that. Now, the guru's coming back somehow. Maybe. I was driving on the freeway today. This Honda Odyssey van is merging in front of me. So I say, okay, merge. I slow down. I'm in the slow lane. I'm letting them merge. And they slow down. They see me and they slow down. I say, well, come on. I mean, you're ahead of me. Merge. And then I say, well, maybe I should speed up there. I say, no, there's not room. Let me slow down, you know, more. And so I slow down more. What do they do? They slow down more. You go ahead, you know. And so we played this game of, we kept slowing down because I said, look, you're merging on the freeway. I'm behind you. I'm slowing down. That's a sure sign. I want you to speed up and merge. This is the driving, you know, ABC. So if we're in a slow lane and someone's merging us and we can see they're a little bit ahead of us and we slow down, you know, that's a sign for them to accelerate. But they didn't. They braked. And I said, well, let me go ahead. And they said, wait a minute. You know, it's okay. So this is what happened. And I said, wow. And finally, I just really slowed down so much. They finally merged ahead of me and we're still going slow. I said, holy cow. You got to drive better than this. This is terrible driving. It's very timid driving. It's too timid. Honda Odyssey's got, they got acceleration capabilities. Honda engines can accelerate. So accelerate. Good God. Well, I looked behind me in the rearview mirror just to make sure they hadn't caused a problem behind me. And there was this pickup truck towing this big flatbed trailer. And the trailer was just fishtailing all over the freeway. Going into the middle lane, and it would fishtail on the shoulder. I mean, it was terribly fishtailing, and the rear end of the truck was just, you know, going back and forth. Oh, my gosh, it was almost an accident, very close to being an accident. I saw that, and I said, good Lord, look what happens if, you know, you don't merge properly. I said, you know, this is probably timid, you know, either it's an elderly person or an Asian driver. They tend to be very polite. Asian drivers think, well, oh, you know, I'll let you go first, even though I'm ahead of you, you know, even though you've slowed down. But how can I get ahead of you if I've already slowed down and you're already merging? I mean, it just doesn't make any sense. It's not good driving. But so I said, okay. So I accelerated around them to see. And there's this little old Indian lady, you know, driving there. From India, and you know, she's just looking at it like this. I said, ah, okay. just too, you know, too polite, you know, too trying to be, and just the culture is that just, you know, I don't want to push anybody. I'm very nice. I said, ah, okay, I see, okay. You know, they're not hip to the culture here. So many drivers now in the Silicon Valley are from all over the world. They don't know how to drive in America. They really don't. And they cause a lot of problems. But anyway, I took this as a sign. I didn't get upset or mad. I said, okay, I'm fine. I cooled down and just, oh, everything's great. But I said, I'm sorry that this truck almost crashed. But then I said, you know, what does this mean? What does this mean? Class is half full. What does this mean? Well, this little Indian lady merging, what it means, coming from somewhere else, which is calmer and quieter and more peaceful, merging onto this really busy, you know, this busy, busy world. Rush, 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 rush of the freeway, and bringing that calm slowness onto this freeway, causing me to slow down, causing me to slow down, causing me to slow down, and causing this, what, this truck with the trailer, what is that, two-ness, duality, and causing duality to fishtail, or causing duality to get all out of whack. And I said, hey, that would be a good thing, actually. So in some way, I took it as symbolizing something really great is coming. Help something helping us slow down. Calmer, peaceful. I was able to break and break and break, and I kept my cool. It wasn't easy. But maybe this was a sign that this is something that's coming, that we're able to just, let's just abide in the holy instant and forget about the world. This world, this hustle bustle world. I'm ready to forget about it. I really feel I'm ready to drop out of this world. I feel like a dropout. Really feel like a dropout. I really am not interested in the world anymore, and what's happening in the world, and the trends, and, you know, what the future will be. I don't care. I don't care. I'm not part of it. I'm not going to be part of it in that way at all. This is really my mentality. Not easy for younger people, I understand, but they may catch something of it, actually, because they're feeling like, wow, I have to work, what can I do? But for me, I just said, I've had enough of this world, I'm finished with it. I have no interest, I really have no interest in the future of this world and what happens here, don't care. It's somebody else's world now, it's not mine. Just like you say, well, you know, that's not my president, well, this is not my world. Is this my world anymore? So I don't care. You know, let those who think it's their world, let them worry about the world. I'll just abide in the holy instant, the non-dual holy instant, and make this my new norm. Now, it feels good because I'm focusing on something way better. It's dangerous to try and drop out of the world just in a negative way. I'm doing it in a positive way. We're doing this in a positive way, very positive. Abidance in the holy instant, honoring time, regaining our freedom. This is very positive. It's the most positive, you know, outcome we could possibly have. So I know this is possible. So this is why I know that I already am abiding in the holy instant. That's my new norm. This is a positive. Now, if you just become depressed, say, I can't, nothing, I don't like anything in the world, I can't get interested in anything, this is horrible, then this is a bad, dangerous thing, you know. don't want to do that. So this is what we're doing here is an intentional discipline for those who are very spiritually motivated to introduce better habits, something better than the world, better than time worshiping. The world is nothing but time worshiping. There really isn't a world. There's simply time worshiping going on. And we call that time worshiping a world. You know, where did that word come from? Who said it's a world? What does a world, what does that term mean anyway? It's really, all that's happening is just time worshiping is happening. And we can shift over to honoring time instead of worshiping time. So again, who said this is a world? Who said this? That we live in a world. We just accept this, right? This, but really? How do we know it's a world? Why do we call it a world? Why do we call anything by the names we call it, actually? Is that really what it is? Or is it just time worshiping, mental projections? Mental projection. Who said we're living? Who said this is living? Who said this is? Who defined that this is living? Who defined that this is living in a world? Where's this coming from? It's just familiarity of use of language, right? I mean, we don't question it, we don't challenge it. Who said there's an I that is living in a world? Who said there's an I? Who said there's living? Who said there's a world? This is just all a fantasy, a mental projected fantasy of time worshiping. Who said this is a house, you know? Who said this is dirt? We have all these images of everything, labels of everything. But it's all just one time worshiping projection. There's a song by Group Chicago, I think. Does anybody really know what time it is? Does anybody really care? Who said it's 12 o'clock? Who said it's 11 o'clock? Is it really? What is 11 o'clock? Is the world 11 o'clock? Right here, the world? Is there a world that is 11 o'clock? Is there a body that it's 11 o'clock? Is there really? We use these terms and we think we know what we're really talking about, but maybe not. knowledge can weave a spell on upon us. So say, I don't know what anything is. I don't know anything. I don't know what anything is. I don't know what anything is. I don't know any isness. I don't know isness right now. I don't know what anything is. Maybe there aren't any things. Maybe there's only isness. We call cars a car, but is it really a car there? It's a bunch of sheet metal. We call it sheet metal. Is it really sheet metal? We call metal metal. Is it really metal? Is metal really there? Is that really what is there? There is just a word. And do we touch something that this then tells us what is there? What is? We call it. Oh, I just touched metal. This is how metal feels. Is that really metal? Is this really how it feels? Just because our fingers give a sensation to us? Is that what's actually there? Or do our bodies tell us what's actually there? Does our language tell us what's actually there? Is there anything actually there at all? Actually, really? Is what everything is to our body, is that what it is? So seeing everything as it is the new norm, is my new norm. Seeing everything as it is my new norm. Seeing all as it is my new norm. Abidance in the holy instant is my new norm. Abidance in the holy instant is my new norm. Ah, I'm getting tired. I've been go today. I'm not taking a rest. Didn't take a rest. And so we're just bringing all this up here. And yeah, do we know anything? Do I know anything? I don't know anything. Is there really thingness? The body tells us, we claim the body tells us there is. Maybe there isn't a thingness, separate thingness. And we can abide in this realization. Abide in the realization of oneness is my new norm. Abiding in the realization of vision of oneness is my new norm. This is my new norm. Abiding in the vision of oneness is my new norm. Abiding in the vision of oneness is my new norm. Abiding in the vision of oneness is my new norm. Say, abiding in the vision of oneness is my new norm. Say, okay, this is my new normal. I'm going to make sure it becomes my new normal. This is what I'm determined to. So I'll work at it, work at it, work at it, work at it. This now is my new normal. Welcome, new normal. Welcome, new normal. Okay. So we're really going fast, and what's next? I don't know. Maybe we'll go even faster. Not maybe, we will. For sure. Very great. That's it for this one.